Rohan is a maxillofacial surgeon in training, a passionate reader and occasional writer. His ultimate aim in life is to finish writing a novel. And Kashyap is going to perform that.
So I am Kashyap. I run a startup called Lokanwala Productions. Self-pitching time. Go to my Facebook page. It's called Lokfundwala. LOW Fundwala. We make budget videos for startups, but I like to say we make startup stories and we tell startup stories. So this piece is called The King of Patiala, Freedom. The king stood on the balcony of his palace. He looked up and saw the full moon shining to its full glory. He looked down to see the people sleeping outside the palace. They were there demanding their right in the decision-making process of the kingdom. The king and the entire royal family were furious at this demand. It was not only unheard of before, but also downright stupid. What would the people know about decision-making? He looked again at the moon. The sight was visibly calmer than the bunch of people lying outside in front of the palace, out in the cold, trying to get their freedom. All this was caused due to this guy from somewhere abroad who came back with some really stupid idea called democracy. Apparently they asked people before taking any decisions. How will anything work out like that? The king was thinking so much into it that it started to give him a headache. His thoughts went back to good and peaceful times. The Minister for Interior Affairs came running to the king. "Minister, my king, you assured me last week that the protesters will be gone in time for my royal buffalo race, but they are still there. How can we have a good race if all these people are standing around? My esteemed guests will then have to stand behind them. I can't let that happen. You should do something." "My king, according to our informants, the reason why they are still standing there is because they are frustrated by the stupid decisions taken by the authorities." "How dare you call my decision stupid?" the king shouted in anger. "Your Highness, it is not I who said that. Our informants told me. But they may be wrong." "They should be. How can they call my decision to provide free milk to the cats of the country to control the mice stupid? The farmers should thank me, and frankly, if we let all the people take all the decisions on matters of administration, the country will go to the dogs in a matter of days or weeks at the most. Do they have any idea of how much difficulty I had to choose the color of the flag this year? You are absolutely right, my king, as always. We will still need to convince the people about it. You are right. Any suggestions?" "My lord, you can address the crowd tomorrow morning." "Yes, that sounds like a good idea. I will tell them to disperse or else I shall unleash my army upon them." "Your Honor, I was thinking of a more diplomatic talk. Tactful use of words so that people will hear what they want to hear. Your speech should have words like freedom, ideals, principles, divine, power, retribution, God, etc. "Well then, ask the speechwriter to make one such speech for the occasion and I shall read it tomorrow. Tell them it should be so good that the people should go away after hearing it. "Well then, ask the speechwriter to make one such. Yes, my lord. And one more thing. Yes, we need to conduct elections, Your Highness." "What? Elections? Have you gone mad, you baboon? My family was appointed by the gods to rule over this land till eternity. The people are fortunate to live in our kingdom." "Yes, my lord. I know that. But these young people are not really convinced of those great ideals. We should convince them by letting them elect their representatives who will talk on their behalf in the decision-making process. The people will then feel they have a voice in their decisions." "But they don't have a voice." "No, they don't, but they feel they have." "Explain yourself, Minister." The king was confused. "Well, first we will make the rules for the election such that only uneducated, jobless people will stand for it. And secondly, once they are elected, we will give them privileges and status so that they will feel special and above the normal people." "The idea sounds good enough, but is it going to work?" "Yes, my king, it will work." "Well then, let us do it tomorrow. for today we will sleep in peace. It is getting too cold in the balcony. The king and the minister retired back to their chambers, while the group of people outside the palace spent the night out in the cold trying to get what they thought was freedom.